What we do here is encourage everyone to keep at it. Keep at it. Keep at it. Keep at it. The non-dual path. The pathless path is something that we need encouragement on, because it's not something we can really define. And so it can seem difficult, and yet tremendous progress is being made, actually. So I'll give some examples today of we may be looking for some really big event. It doesn't seem to happen. We say, Holy Spirit, help, help, help. I need some breakthrough, huge. And nothing seems to happen. But keep paying attention to your day. Don't give up on yourself. You deserve to, we all deserve success in this endeavor, actually. We all deserve ultimate success. Absolutely we do. So here I am today saying, praying, saying, asserting. I can, I will, I've already done it. I can be helped, I will be helped, I've already been helped. This is a very powerful one. I can be helped, I will be helped, I've already been helped. So I actually was helped today, greatly. And so by sharing these little anecdotes, etc., this clues you in, it clues us in, and reminds us, hey, I can be helped, I will be helped, I am being helped, I am being helped. By the Holy Spirit. I can be helped by the Holy Spirit. I will be helped by the Holy Spirit. I am being helped by the Holy Spirit. So I'm on this place, a road. I get out a vehicle, and something strikes my eye. Very out of place. I said, "What is that?" Some bright, shiny, something bright and shiny. And like a magpie, I say, "Oh, what is this?" And I pick it up. It's a brand new nickel. Looking at the back, Monticello, brand new nickel. And this is, you know, why would it be sitting there like that? I don't know. Just okay. I said, wow, very interesting. A nickel, five. I say this is very significant. I felt it's very significant. I was meant to come across this. I said, okay. Later on in the day, I'm at this place of business, and I'm waiting for something. And I say, hey, I got some time to what I'm gonna do. And so I start walking around. I say, Holy Spirit, you know, show me something important here. We really got to make this day count. It's very important. So finally, I sit down. And I'm just looking at the sun getting lower in the sky, and I'm just sitting there, and suddenly I see these five birds in a group. These five birds. And also suddenly I see this big airplane coming into the picture. And I see the airplane and the birds, and they seem to move together like this. In the sky. And I said, wow, there's the five again, taking flight to the fifth what? Taking flight to fifth 5D, five dimension. I don't know, what does it mean? Obviously it means something. And then I said, remember the nickel. Oh my gosh, okay. So the Holy Spirit's saying, hey, taking flight. I've been focusing on this. We know, okay, today's the first day of the Bond Conference, the 19th. Watching this video on the 20th, so it's the second day. 21st is the 50th anniversary of Course in Miracles, the beginning of that. And I was thinking of, what can I do? What kind of graphics can I do? And I just can't come up with anything. I feel terrible, but it doesn't seem to, you know, doesn't seem to really be where it's at. Maybe Jesus will do something for us. You know, I'm trying to do something for him. Maybe say, hey, let me do something for you on this day. We'll see. We'll just let it happen. I go to a place of business today. I'm talking with someone, young person, young man, level headed guy, good guy. And we're talking about. So get into certain things. He tells me about the hideous invasion of crime in his neighborhood where he lives, and how he has to leave because it's impossible to raise children there. He's terrified of it, what's going to happen to the children. They have to lock them inside all the time. I mean, they're just these gangbangers, home invaders, car thieves, just rampant terrorizing the neighborhood. This is happening all over the world, actually, and this is just happening in San Jose, California, actually. Terrible. Even in good neighborhoods. His is not a particularly good one, but he said it used to be fine. But these, and he says that the people are like 13 and 14-year-olds. Young people who are just, he said they're completely sick. He said the whole thing is absolutely revolting and sick. And so he's trying to move out of there, and hopefully he can. So we get to talking, and I said, you know, what about, what do you think is, let me see, how do I put it? The drug situation, because this is what's being highlighted, that I believe that the world is going to go into a intense usage of drugs very soon to usher in, quote-unquote, the new age, okay? A post-industrialized age where industriousness is taboo, except for monitoring everybody. Everyone's industriousness is going to be put into monitoring everybody, so they're going to channel the industriousness of everyone into monitoring. Other than that, if you're not monitoring, you're expected to be docile drone. And he said something very interesting. He said, you know what, I think that maybe they should just legalize all drugs and that would cut down on crime. And then he says, but you know, if we do that, I guarantee you that the world will go on a drug binge, a massive drug binge, for about 5 years. And then after that, they'll probably start saying, oh, wow, this isn't so good. And this is astonishingly like what I had in the prophetic dream, that I've been able to, I believe, narrow it down to drug haze that is coming upon the world. The world is going to be tremendously drugged. They're trying to legalize as many drugs as possible now. There's a big push for that. The young people want it. They want drugs. They want free sex, free drugs, for, you know, free college, free housing, free everything. So here's somebody from the younger generation, out of the blue, saying this, that he believes that this is likely that's going to happen, exactly what I had said in a video and have been talking about. I said, wow. Along with the, you know, the terrible, terrible crime, I'm talking to people about it. Further south you go, the worse it gets. And you know, you go from Mexico, you start going to south. I mean, it's the Mexicans are terrified of, you know, for Salvadorans, for instance, terrified of them. With good reason, you know. It's, you know, we think we're living in this wonderful place. No, there's very affluent, upscale neighborhoods now. They're being terrorized by third world gang members from here, right here in San Jose area. They can't fund the police force. And home invasions in broad daylight, they tie up the people inside, if they're lucky, beat them up, tie them up, and steal everything, you know, whatever they can, whatever they want. And just with impunity. So it's a prison planet in a way. I mean, there's all the, well, criminal planet, drug planet, and yet here we go into the new age. So it's a very, very mixed bag. Okay, fine. What is this five symbol? I have to find out what that means exactly. It's taking flight to, well, I've said that the best place for us is to be in a situation where it feels as if there's no outcomes, because reality has no outcomes. People ask define non-duality. I say, okay, it's that which cannot be, has no definition. That's what it is. And it both is that and is not that. And they say, wow, this is too much. Well, okay. So is non-duality some sort of topic you can discuss? The answer is no. The non-dual is for those who genuinely, truly, more than anything else, want everyone to be free of suffering. And when that is your ultimate priority, then there's a dawning upon you that this is possible. The not only possible, but it's a certainty. It dawns upon you there is indeed a way. But try as you might, you cannot objectify it and turn it into a topic, turn it into a definition. And the more we try to heal, 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 bring about outcomes, the more we remain deluded, actually. That's right. So the new age, meet the new age, same as the old age. We just got fooled again, to paraphrase Pete Townsend, Roger Daltrey, Entwistle, and what's the drummer's name? Bashing the drums. He didn't stick around long enough to have his name remembered. Keith Moon, The Who. Yeah. The discipline is to sit still in the wow. This third option, not right, not wrong, but wow. Not true, not true, but wow. Jesus tells us over and over again, the problem is definition. We're trying to define what we are. We have no definition, which is that is life. And as soon as we try to define what we are, we're believing in death. We've made fear of death. Fear of annihilation. So the continuity fear is afraid of all these definitions that we're trying to define ourselves. So the new age is just a different way of trying to define ourselves. See? Oh, same as the old age. The old age was an old way to try to define ourselves, meaning it's we realize it doesn't work any. So we say, well, that's old, it doesn't work. Let's go something new. Well, the new won't work either. As cutesy as they try to make it. And they're making it very cutesy. Really. All psychic-y, It's very psychic-y and new agey and crystalline-y and all this kind of stuff. And the women are calling the shots because they're the etheric body of women is different than men in a certain way. And they're naturally more psychic. So it all this stuff comes very the psychic comes very easy from there. The astral realmness, psychicness comes very easy. That's why a lot of the channelers are women. I mean, they're completely dominating the spiritual, the psychic new age scene, completely dominating it. They're calling the shots. They will call the shots in the new age, and the men are simply drones, simply drones. But again, meet the new age, same as the old age. We just got fooled again. So we say non-dual. It's something that we have to immerse ourselves in as a dedication. It can only be related to in a way through dedication. See, only, you cannot we cannot relate to it through argumentation. We cannot relate to it through discussion. We can only relate to it through being immersed in it and this is the only way. And immersion is immersion. You might say it's just eternal immersion. And definition, I say, well, what is it you're not immersed in? Or what it isn't any such condition, actually. So our dedication, our immersion, our determination, our dedication, our commitment, this is the only way to really relate with what we say non-dual. It's the only way to relate is that's it. Can never be a topic. Can never be a topic. Can never be an academic subject. It's impossible. Will never be so. But those who are dedicated, they know that they're onto something, okay? Onto what truth, they're onto what they really want. What everyone really wants. Now, it's very difficult in this world. When you try to relate with people and explain, you go right into duality again, and it's terrible. I mean, I've had to do a little explaining recently, and I don't know, maybe it's a good thing, maybe it's a bad thing, I don't know. Non-dual often is best done in self-study, so you don't get into discussing, arguing, topics, talking about it, all this stuff. This is what cuts you off from it, your awareness of it. This is what causes you to lose momentum, actually. So, of course, the miracle is a self-study. It's designed for self-study. Just do it on your own, basically. And otherwise, you're going to slow down. And that's no good. It's not just slowing down. You won't feel immersed in it. And therefore, you feel you've lost it. Immersion is it. That's a great way to put it, isn't it? Immersion is it. Not chasing after immersion. Not chasing after healing, not chasing after, not arguing about immersion, not discussing immersion. Immersion is it. We would say, I'm completely immersed. There's only complete immersion. That's all there is. Complete immersion is all there is. From a definitional point, it's pure abstraction, isn't it? But it's both is and is not pure abstraction. So in other words, abstraction isn't abstraction because we're talking about it. So we have to continually practice. It's not what we're talking about. It's never what we're talking about. It's never what we're saying. But pragmatically, we can say both is and isn't because we're used to talking and expressing. And so we want to honor that. So it both is and isn't. And neither is not nor is. It either is not nor is. It neither is not abstraction nor is it abstraction. So that makes us feel a little safer. It neither is not nor is. Either is not nor is. How about that? It neither is not abstraction nor is it abstraction. Abstraction neither is not abstraction, nor is it abstraction. Abstraction neither is not abstraction, nor is it abstraction. Immersion neither is not immersion, nor is it immersion. Immersion neither is not immersion, nor is it immersion. This is a new form of the practice here. It's just happened. This is very interesting. I've been looking for this form of practice, actually. Well, there's a gift from Jesus and the Holy Spirit right now, right? This is a way of using a positive, like we say, hey, we want immersion, but instead of, you can also say, I neither reject immersion, nor do I not reject immersion. That's another way of putting it. But we can say also, immersion neither is not immersion, nor is it immersion. Abstraction neither is abstraction, nor is not nor is abstraction. So we put the second one that we want to say, it's abstraction is not abstraction. We put that last. So first we reassure ourselves. So our practicing, what we do is first we reassure our continuity fear. This lowers the defensiveness of us. And then we say, you know, what is really very germane, that abstraction is not abstraction. You see, now this is the core of getting to this. Abstraction is not abstraction. And it's like, whoa, I can feel the wow when I say that. Very strong. So we go back to saying, abstraction neither is not abstraction, nor is it abstraction. And this smooths out the wow. It smooths out the wow. So if you're having trouble with the wow, this is a way of practicing. Again, we are not going for what is true, nor what is not true. We're going for the wow, actually. Because we're going for what is true is actually a definition. So it's very important to rest in this wow, which is really, we're practicing immersion. It's really like getting used to immersion, actually. Immersion in what? No, just immersion. As soon as we say what, immersion in what? That's back to duality, right? There's only immersion. That's all there is. There's only the allness. That's another way to put it. But immersion is experiencing is one of feeling just this perfect immersion. And all is, since it's endless and eternal, all is this immersion. All is this immersion. There's no boundaries, no seams to this immersion. It's not we're immersed in something. It's not like we are the immersion. There's only immersion. And again, the reaction to this should not be one that this is a topic we're talking about. The reaction is, wow. Wow. And there's a sort of a shakiness to the wow, right? Which is great. It's great to feel the wow. This is what we should go after, that, you know. This is our goal, right? In life, you feel this wow, this genuine wow. Don't try to go after artificial wows. This is a huge mistake. Go after the genuine wow, which has to do with looking directly at this immersion. Just immersion. Not I am immersed, not this is immersed, just immersion. And you feel this fear, this elation and trepidation that is kind of shaky, like you're like jittery. Okay. Now, the personality tells us, oh, that's what you don't want. Flee away from that. Flee. Oh, no. You've gone into bad, wrong territory. No, it's just the opposite. We're going into right territory. The territory, free territory. You see? Immersion is not a territory. Immersion is neither not a territory, nor is it a territory. Immersion neither is not a territory, nor is it a territory. Immersion is just immersion. There's only immersion. So, feel this jitteriness. This is super good. In other words, you say, hey, my cup is half full. Look at this. That's tremendous. Where if you listen to the ego personality, it will say, oh my gosh, what are you? You're thinking wrong. You're going to go crazy. You're thinking wrong. Got to get away from that. Oh. But if you're on the path, if you truly want everyone to be liberated from misery, the misery of pretension, then you will have the right orientation, and it will be a wow for you, and you'll welcome the wow. You'll welcome the wow. Absolutely, the wow! I live for it. Say, please, I told the Holy Spirit, I need a huge wow today. Please, every day, give me the wow. Gotta have it today. And again, chasing artificial wows is the ego's game. The ego says, hey, if you like the wow, oh, okay, no problem. Just stay away from the content that gave rise to it, okay? Because that's bad content. But I'll give you a wow, you know. But divorce it, separate it from, you know, what gave rise to the cause of it. So then the ego gives you these artificial thrills and says, see, yeah, you like that wow. And actually, we say, well, actually, I don't really like it that much. If you're honest, you say, that was terrible. I was looking back on my life and all the, you know, experiencing, and I said, wow, it's all terrible. I didn't really like any of it. The whole thing of being young, all the sensations of the body stuff, terrible. Hated it. It was like some hideous torture you have to go through, really. But the ego saying, oh, no, you know, look at the thrill of this, thrill of that, adrenaline rush. But do we really, is that what we really want? Is that the question? The answer is, of course not. Heck no. That's what we really don't want. We don't really want sensations. Absolutely not. Hey, I hate sensations, actually. And people say, well, there's something wrong with you. No, there's something wrong with those who crave sensations. They have a severe continuity fear problem. So this wow is the one sensation that we allow. Okay, this wow is the one sensation that we allow. It's because of our continuity fear. We're not going to willing to drop sensations altogether. But as we sit quietly and look together at what we need to look at, the wow arises, and it's elation and fear. It's like, oh, I'm finally going to get free of sensations. Hallelujah. And the other part is saying, whoa, I don't know, you know, is that safe? And we're taught that sensations is life. You see, we're taught this incredibly insane notion that sensations means life. No, it means that we're pretending not to be alive. Jesus says that when we're truly abiding, the body has no feeling, no sensation whatsoever, actually. Neither positive nor negative. It's just neutral. We see it correctly, body seen correctly, it's just neutral. But for us, with our continuity fear, we have to be pragmatic here and practice. I mean, it's easy for Jesus to say this, and we're glad that he does. But for our standpoint, the continuity fear implies necessity for pragmatism. So we have to practice. Now, Jesus doesn't have to practice, but we do. And he tells us this. We do have to practice. So we say there's neither there's neither not immersion, nor is there immersion. There is neither not immersion, nor is there immersion. So we're practicing letting go of the concept of immersion, the sensation of immersion, the physical experiencing of immersion. You see, we're so used to believing that physical experiences are true experiences when they're not. They're not at all. They're imaginary. So if we have, when we have this experience, say, wait a minute, I'm not physically experiencing it. How do I physically experience this? This is the problem. And then we lose it. We lose it. Just that brings up a big wow too. Wow. Now don't try to solve this conundrum. You say, oh my gosh, that's the mistake I've been making. Right. It's the mistake we're all making. Okay, so you're not alone. You see, when you're on this path, the pathless path, that is neither not a path nor a path. you realize that the problem we have here is the same that problem that everyone has. It's just that we're aware of it now, and they are not. And we know how to approach this, and they do not yet. That's the only difference. We try to turn it into a physical experience, and that's where it slips through our fingers. So, you know, the old thing, if you don't try to grab the truth, because if you do, it'll slip through your fingers. When we say trying to grab the truth, what we mean is trying to make it a physical experience. Meaning a special experience of being immersed in something. The body wants to be immersed in something. There's no immersion in something. We are immersion itself. But when we, it's so don't, let's not try to solve this right off the bat, right? Just recognize it. The recognition of this is extremely important. We usually get in our own way because we don't recognize the extreme importance of the insights we have. And we say, well, yeah, but how do I solve it? You know, immediately we go into this mode of, okay, but how do I solve it? And I can't solve it, and they grow all frustrated. No, you see, this is the mistake we make because we're trying to turn it again into a physical experience instead of a wow. So instead of just rest in the wow, which is kind of is and is not a physical experience, right? It's sort of a borderline thing. It's both sensation and not sensation in a way. Just to see what the problem is, this is the most important step. So don't short-circuit it by saying, okay, I thought, well, how do I solve it? This is the problem. This is the mistake that we're all making, have been making for so long. Okay, but how do I solve it? No. Just see it and say, wow. This is fantastic. This is tremendous. Great job. Gratitude to the Holy Spirit. Take a gratitude stop. Slow down for gratitude to yourself for doing such a great job. So we're saying, we say like, oh, this is only a mind experience. But how do I make the body join me in the experience? This is why I try to grab it and it slips through our fingers, it's gone. There's only the mind experience. The body's just a symbol of not experiencing. How do we make a symbol of non-experiencing experience? Well, obviously you cannot. It's just an imaginary symbol of not experiencing. There's no such thing as not experiencing in the mind, actually. So don't look for practicing for answers. Look for the wow. When we look for the wow and allow the wow, the answers will arise for us because we're ready to receive them. We're in the right state of mind to recognize. This is how it works. So we have to get that first. We're in the mood for the wow, the genuine wow. And then the answers begin to arise, and we say, wow, I've never seen that before. I mean, I've never seen it so clearly before. This is very, very profound. Great. This is the secret to the path, is first commit to the wow. So when you commit for everyone to be free of suffering, wow, because you're saying, I believe it's possible. And that's the first wow. Or you say, deep down, I know it's possible. Not only possible, but already true. It's already been accomplished. It's already the truth. We're just actually honoring the idea that it's not possible. But that idea that it's not possible only lasted for an instant. It had no continuation at all. It just was an instant and gone like that. Just so. The idea of time didn't have any time to it. Okay? So we're just honoring the memory of that instant. That stillborn instant that didn't, you know, we said, I don't like that. I don't really want to, I can't pursue that. It's just a dead end sort of thing. Time is, it doesn't exist. Is, you know, I can't, there's no such, no way to experience time. It doesn't even exist. So, you know, how can we experience what can never be? It's not possible. How can we experience a change in reality? We cannot. So, but we're honoring the idea of experiencing a change in reality, even though there is no change in reality. So even though in our honoring, we're pretending as though there's a change in reality, but there really hasn't been. It's all pretense. So the knowingness that this is so is in everyone. But when we decide that we're going to accept this knowingness, then we are, as it were, immersed in the in this belief. For a while, we're immersed in the belief. Yeah. We can say that. We can say whatever we want to say. But we begin to feel the wow. The wow begins to arise, and we begin to notice, wow, this is really... This, I'm in a whole different situation. I'm in a whole different vibe here. It's intense. It's different than thinking and talking and reading and all this. It's different. We're in a different boat. There's a way to put it. We're really in a different boat now. And you realize I'm in a different boat. And then you keep getting used to that boat. As you see the world, you know, they're in a different boat. They're talking, they're thinking, they're discussing, they're planning, they're strategizing, they're arguing about this and that, and they're, you know, just, it's a different boat. They haven't yet committed. They haven't said, this is what I truly want. I know this is what I really want, so this is what I'm going to go for. I'm going to go for it. It's go time. Now, speaking of go time, it is go time today. This is how I define the era that we live in right now. It's really not the new age so much. We're in a transition time, but it's go time. Means what you prepared for, this go for it. This is what you go, everyone's going now to what they've prepared for. They're getting into it now. Are we getting into it? We're both getting into it and not getting into it. We're neither not getting into it, nor are we getting into it. We're neither not getting into it, nor are we getting into it. We're neither not getting into it, nor are we getting into it. We're neither not getting into it, nor are we getting into it. Now, you ask about progress. Well, here's progress. This practice, I couldn't do it before. Yesterday, I said, I know there's some way to do it. I just can't come up with it. And today, it just popped in my mind as I just sat down to tape here. Boom. There's right there evidence of tremendous progress. I'm neither not getting into it, nor am I getting into it. I'm neither not getting into it, nor am I getting into it. And we say, well, how can I explain this? I neither cannot explain it, nor can I explain it. I can neither not explain it, nor can I explain it. So what's very important when you're practicing like this is don't put yourself in the role of actually thinking about, well, how can I explain to people once I'm finished practicing? This totally short circuits the practice and becomes completely ineffective then. So you have to be willing to actually practice. It's a little scary, isn't it? You say, oh, well, I don't know. It's fine. It's fine. I've never had any problem at all. When you go back to the world, you just function as normal, like a person, like you're used to functioning. It's like riding a bike or something. I mean, it's not a problem. But while we're practicing, instead of entertaining the scenario, okay, well, how am I going to explain it to other people? Instead, we practice and say, I'm neither not going to explain it nor am I going to explain it. I'm neither not going to explain it nor am I going to explain it. It's neither not explainable nor is it explainable. It's neither not explainable nor is it explainable. And so we don't think how other people think about us now because we're practicing. It has nothing to do with what they think about us or say. This is practice. So that whole dualistic scenario is put to the side. It's put to the side. We're sidestepping it. When we're practicing, we're sidestepping. So we full stop in the while. We don't think ahead, like, well, what are we going to say to people? How are we going to explain that we're neither explaining nor explaining? Don't entertain that notion. Okay, but of course, as soon as I say don't, you're going to start entertaining it, of course. So both, neither not entertain it nor entertain it. Neither not entertain it nor entertain it. Go right back to practicing. So whatever arises, turn it into a practice. Here's what musicians do. Something occurs to them in their mind, and the real talented ones, they immediately start practicing, trying to say, let me put this into a practice. Let me put this into practice. As soon as they're thinking, well, I wonder how people might respond to this. I wonder. As soon as they do that, the creative process, it dries up. It dries up. You just have to let the riff play itself out. Let the song play itself. Don't get in the way of the song. Don't be an audience member, you see? Sidestep the audience. You have to sidestep the audience. You have to sidestep the audience that is expecting explanation. Yeah, sidestep. So the non-dual path might be said sidestepping the non-dual path, sidestepping the audience. The path of sidestepping the path. It's a hideous thing to worry about. How can you explain what is not explainable? Isn't that just a terrible demand that we place upon one another? That's why I said everyone should practice silence and just stop demanding that anyone, explain. So this really here is not really an explanation. It's an immersion, right? Different. This is why the videos are so long. To help us with this immersion, because ultimately this is what we're going towards. We're going towards abidance is another term for immersion. But there's nothing being immersed, you see? It's all immersion. There's not something that arrived from somewhere else and jumped into the ocean. Oh, I'm immersed in the ocean now. No, it doesn't. All is the ocean. There's always been only immersion. And there's neither not been, always been immersion, nor has there always been immersion. Meaning, whatever you say about it is both is and is not it. What does immersion need to be said about it? Does it have some need? There's an assumption it has needs. That's a body thing, thinking that, well, how do I meet this need in my body for immersion? How do I meet this need? So we try to turn it into a need. I need to be immersed. So I neither don't need to be immersed, nor do I need to be immersed. I neither don't need to be immersed, nor need to be immersed. So you can see how, as I'm talking, flipping the script, before it starts going towards, in my mind, dealing with the resistance of the world, flip that and turn it into a practice. Flip it and turn it into a practice. This is how you get strength. This is how we do it, okay? Now, honoring Jesus, what's the best way to honor Jesus? I figure, well, do a taping and help him out by helping with this immersion, you know, helping out this way. Why not? Isn't that his whole purpose? He said this is for teachers of God. Well, that's what we're doing here. So this is honoring the effort, you know, the great effort and responsibility that he put forth is by doing the work here, doing another workout. I don't know how else to honor it, really. This is the best way I can think of. I don't know what else I can do, you know. Putting up a cool graphic, I just don't think that's quite it. It's practicing. I mean, he called us to practice. This full stop in the wow is really where it's at. If we don't have a wow in our practice, we're not practicing well. And we need to try again and try again. Keep allowing it. You know that this is, we go into it with saying, okay, I'm ready. I'm ready for some intense wow to arise. Absolutely. And of course, sitting still is the best way for the wow to allow the wow to rise. As long as we're thinking about moving the body in some way, as long as we're focused on the body, the energy of the body, the sensations of the body, moving the body, anything about the body, this obstructs the wow from arising. We say, well, I'm not ready for the wow yet. And then, therefore, the insight recognitions don't arise. This is why sitting quietly like this, not putting your attention on the body, is so important. So the way to do that is instead of, you know, trying to not have sensation, trying to forget the body, this is a way it doesn't work. Instead of that, just say, wow. I'm here and I'm practicing. Wow. I'm committed. Wow. I feel like I will have success. Wow. So this gives us this sort of vague, fuzzy sensation, non-sensation. And it's sufficient. That's enough. That remains. So we're honoring our creativity, right? We're not trying to block the body out or do anything like that. We just accept that this is what ultimately will take place, but we're honoring our creativity. So the wow, you know, it's not that we're trying to be a statue or any, we're not trying to force it or attain that anything. That this is what gets in the way. This is what gets in the way. That's a non-artful, non-wise approach. They say that, of course, Nando, you've heard it say, well, you know, if you're trying to be silent, you're getting in the way of silence. But that raises a conundrum, right? They say, well, you just have to let it happen. But if you're trying to let it happen, you're getting in the way of it happening. It goes on and on. There's no end to it. So what we do is we don't get caught in that trap. We say, no, I'm neither not trying to be silent, nor am I trying to be silent. I'm actually intentionally allowing the wow. It's not silence, is it? It's not freedom from sensation, no. That's okay. It's evaporating our continuity fear. without this struggle to, I've got to try and be silent. I've got to try and be still. I've got to try and do this. Now we just say, hey, I'm not putting that burden. You know, this is, this gets in the way of trying to set goals and outcomes like this. So we're just using it, this overall basket of all outcomes, all trying, all everything, just full stop on the wow. Be immersed in the wow. That's all. Be just immersed in the wow. This is the feeling that arises when we're really focused on truth. He's like, wow, this is very intense. Wow. But don't try to make the wow intense. In other words, full stop in the wow. If we're trying to make it intense, intentionally, it's not full stop. We just let the wow be as it is. And just feel gratitude and just feel like, hey, I'm doing a great job here. This is great. Don't try to intensify it nor get rid of it. Neither one. This song, Smokey, was that Smokey Robinson? I'm gonna fly away. I'm gonna fly. Oh, it keeps playing in my mind over and over, looping over and over. Hope you're going my way. I'm gonna fly away. And I saw those birds flying, paralleling this airplane in flight. Now, five can be seen as two on one side, two on another side, and one in the middle, right? Two symbolizes duality. So neither nor, it's duality on this side, duality on that side, but I'm immersed. I'm neither not immersed, nor am I immersed, okay? Now this, we might call this fifth stage practice, actually. Maybe we've actually gone into fifth. Well, I would say fifth stage practice is actual experiencing the immersion, I would say. So let's think about that five, number five. Think about it as two dots on this side, two dots on this side, and the one is right in the middle, so to speak. So neither not immersed nor am I immersed. I'm neither immersed nor am I not immersed. I'm neither not immersed nor am I immersed. Okay, so think of it this way. I'm neither immersed nor am I not immersed. I'm neither not immersed nor am I immersed. Okay. And the experiencing is immersion. There is only immersion. The experience is only immersion. Just that. You might say the symbol of immersion, it could be something like this. Symbolize it too. I'm neither immersed nor am I immersed. I'm neither not immersed nor am I immersed. This is why spiritual path, they say, cut down on bodily sensations. This is what interferes with it. If we're craving body sensations, this is what interferes with our success. Because we'll try to turn immersion into a body sensation. So that's why you have to ask the question, well, why you know, is this religion so strict about all this stuff? And this right there points out how the New Age is very troublesome. Very heavily into the body and body sensation, focusing on the body. They want to spiritualize the body is what they want to do. They claim that it was possible to divinize the body, spiritualize the body, spiritualize the world, and all this stuff. This is highly problematical. Always, spiritual path go throughout history. It's they say, hey, you've got to cut down on the sensations and everything that gets you into your body and into sensations. Just pay it no heed, no interest. I'm not interested in that. Don't pay attention to the body. Don't follow the cravings of the body. Actually, there are no cravings of the body. The body actually is neutral. We're just projecting cravings upon it. Don't project those cravings upon it. Don't try to immerse yourself in sensation. Because we're saying that something is immersed in sensation. This, what we're looking for in immersion, we say the body, we're trying to think the body, how does the body get immersed? See, there's only immersion. There's nothing being immersed in immersion. There's only the allness. There's nothing being in the allness. So there's no sensation of something being in the allness. Sensation is the pretension of not being in the allness. And again, don't try to understand this. Just hear it. There's already a knowing within. Just trust in the knowing within. Don't say something else needs to understand it. It's not an understanding we're going toward. It's a knowing. It's an acceptance. It's an immersion. It's immersion itself. As soon as we think about something being immersed, we're believing in time. We're honoring time again. Right back to honoring time. But we don't have to honor time that way. We can honor time this way. I'm neither not immersed, nor am I immersed. I'm neither immersed, nor am I not immersed. Okay. We can honor time this way, right? Remember the number five, okay? Maybe that's a little mnemonic device for enlightenment, actually, for immersion, for the immersion. We can't even explain it, can we? Because no one's being immersed. Just the allness of immersion. Even immersion is not immersed in immersion. There is no immersion in immersion. Okay. The five. Just think of that. That's the five. 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 Oh, yeah. This may help us in abidance. Now, it may seem as though there's some sort of abidance. Some very vague or fuzzy sort of thing. But that's fine. We don't have to